another woman, you know, in England. And she was like, where do you think you're going? I'm like, Northern Ireland. Don't you ever think of going that place? So I started thinking to myself, should I go? But I really wanted to come.
My name is Jan. I come from Slovakia 3 years ago. And this is my brother, Peter. I'm playing the bass, he's playing the drums.
I've met a fabulous, you know, group of musicians and can always benefit from one another.
Working with all these other musicians, learning from our cultures, that music speaks one voice.
We're just people, you know, and the kind of stereotypical images or the fears about different culture or somebody who's different colour kind of disappear and people ask questions. That's what it's about, getting people to talk to one another.
It's quite strange, because in 2003, I remember walking through the doors in the City Hall there for a project, and then it's had a knock-on effect. Now, 5 years later, here we are, doing a film about some amazing journey we've all been on. Sticking to what you know, I think, is the key. And being a musician, to bring people from all different cultures together who have an interest in music and learn about their styles or different instruments and all has just been fantastic. I mean, it's saved me a fortune on travel tickets as well. You know, they've come to me. I've took the lazy route, you know. I have had, you know, a good fortune to travel a lot, you know, but there's no way I'd be able to meet people from so many countries in all my lifetime as I have here on my own doorstep. It's just really enriched the whole cultural aspect of Belfast in a massive way that I don't think a lot of people have recognised, you know. The cliche of universal language and all, like, you know, it is true, you know, and it just goes through so many barriers. It's, you know, it's a magical force. It's kind of a mystical force as well, spiritual, it's all there, you know, and if we can use music to understand our similarities and differences, then that's the way to go, you know.
I want to record a prayer song with Gal and Jenny first.
I think the most poignant thing is my father. He had a really beautiful voice. And he used to chant Baha'i prayers in Persian and Arabic. The sound is like a very melancholy sound of a bird in love. That's the only way I can describe it. It's a very lonely, very solitary but very beautiful sound. My dad had that kind of a voice, and I guess I've kind of inherited something of the sound from my dad. Zhenya is a Russian name. My mother was born in Russia, so they gave me a Russian name. Although I was born in Persia or Iran, prior to the revolution, my family left. And I went to secondary school in England. I didn't speak a word of English. The isolation that I felt in the first year or so when I was in England had a lasting impact on me, on my character. So I can be very, very out there, but I can also be very, very private. And I guess that's much of, you know, much the same for many artists. And then about a year ago, I saw the Motion Project performing. But I love the way they came from different parts of the world. Oh, a mishmash of sounds from all over, and people look from all over, and there was a real gelling of people. It's not about the perfection of music in any way, but it is about the experience of just being and just living.
the idea was, you know, let's gallop some musicians, hire out a couple of recording studios, invite people in and see what happens. It's been an organic process for Motion, something we haven't really pushed, it's just happened naturally.
Whenever you first start actually recording or playing, performing publicly, your confidence isn't high, but you know, Darren, who sort of spearheaded the project, he was always, you know, oh, try it, you know, don't bother, which is really nice, and it really helps your confidence, and then you find out what kind of works for you and what doesn't work for you. I think it's really smart to use music as a way to broach the diversity issues that we face here. Because music, to me, music is a really universal language. You know, everybody can get together and understand, you know, what a really slow violin means to a mood. You know, that might conjure up a certain type of feeling. Whereas, you know, if you have a big heavy rock drum line, you know, that conjures up a different type of feeling, but everyone has those feelings and everybody can relate to those feelings. So I think music was a really intelligent way to try and bring people together, because they're all speaking the same language, and it's just the language of, I don't know, the language of the heart or language of emotion.
Today we're going to have lots of fun, hopefully. We are going to get the kids so hyper that the teachers will not know what hit them. And of course, increase their awareness about you know, the different cultures involved, the different styles of music from around the world. And also, I think just so they can see the interaction, and without getting too heavy, hopefully they also pick up that people can mix and work together in this environment, which we call our band.
I'm the same. There's 32 guys from Poland. Which two do you think it might be? Do you think it might be Jan?
Yeah.
Daniel?
Yeah.
You think it's Darren?
Yeah.
Do you think it's Chris?
Yeah.
Chris and Daniel are both from Poland.
Must have been about 16. I was hanging out with a crowd, and I didn't really realise what was going on until one day they saw a stranger coming into the estate, and the next thing is, he doesn't live here, let's go and give him a kicking. But for me, that wasn't where I wanted to go. So coincidentally, I just I'd been working in the Stormont Hotel as a waiter, and I'd be working nights in there and saved up money, and that's how I got my first drum kit. I remember it was a few pounds short, and my mum gave me the difference, and I got a second-hand kit. And that, I think that really, the combination of having something to do and also having something that I felt I was good at. I was okay at football, but I was never going to sign for Man United. I couldn't even get on the school A team. It was like I played in the B team. But the one thing that I was good at quite quickly, and I found confidence in, was drumming. So maybe from self-esteem, that was good. And also from the practical point of view, that had something to focus in on. I'd probably get on better with kids than I do adults. which gives me a chance to be like Peter Pan, and I usually have a lot of fun, you know. Kids are great.
Started getting feedback from schools and colleges and all saying, you know, what you guys do, it's not really a workshop, it's more like an experience, because it was kind of high energy, a lot of fun. And we kept getting these evaluations back, you know, 15 years of teaching, I've never seen anything like this before, this is not a workshop, you know. It was really a case of giving children, young people, adults, the opportunity to meet somebody from different culture in a kind of environment of creativity through music.
City called Tongling. It's just very close to Shanghai. Take about 6 hour trains. My father, he's a composer. They trained me when I was 4, and just started piano playing and doing composition when I was 8. Then around 10 years old, they sent me to Shanghai doing the music in Shanghai Conservatory of Music. We studied French, German, Russian, and Chinese systems. We don't do UK, British, or Irish systems. So, and I was very interested in Irish, you know, Celtic music, and I found that it's very similar to Chinese folk music. So it got me very, very interested. I just thought I need to come here to study something I cannot learn in China. My life was horrible before I met Darren. I wanted to go back to China, I don't want to stay here. But then Darren contacted me, and I found that this project would be interesting. And then I went to the motion and saw a lot of friends there, musicians there. And I just found I still can stay here for happiness. So that's just stay here.
I must say Northern Ireland is great because it developed, first of all, my confidence, it developed my freedom, and also it's a good country when it's regarding disability. I believe that music is my therapy. My family went to France because my two sisters were already blind. And my mom tried to find a solution to try to get our sight back. But unfortunately, the doctors couldn't find what was wrong with us. Basically, I was pushed in studies. I did a bit of too much. What happened is I cracked and I had depression, and I went four times in the hospitals, and I stayed only a period of 2 weeks time. But when I was in hospital, I thought, well, nobody loves me in the family. But I felt the nurses, their kindness, their affection, the way they were talking to me, I felt that, yeah, well, someone loves me. Music is part of my freedom. When I don't have music, I just don't feel well. One of the cultures I'm very interested in is the African culture. Oh yes, I would love to go to a music seminar in Africa and play my drums out there. And I just hope that one day the motion will get a gig in Africa, because if it happened, I'd be packing on the plane away I go.
This is an experience which the asylum seekers face. A title is called A Long Way From Home. Africa.
Zimbabwe, it's a very beautiful country, you know, but most of the people there are all going away because of the troubles which are going on. When you're in Zimbabwe, it doesn't matter what qualifications you have, you know, so you can't get any job. You can't do nothing unless if you have anyone who's right on top to, you know, to pull you up, you know. But as far as I saw it, you know, things were just like going from bad to worse. Mr. Mugabe's government, they are trying to pull all the musicians so that they can support him, because with music, I think it's a very big tool which you can spread the word to people. I used to play with a guy called Andy Brown. He's a very famous musician back home in Zimbabwe. Andy Brown didn't used to play any political songs, but he was just like neutral, you know. So they took Andy Brown and they started paying him some money, you know, so he started writing some songs, you know, supporting the ZANU-PF, which is Mr. Mugabe's party. So I was starting to have some problems. When I was coming from a gig somewhere else in Masvingo, they took my shoes, they, you know, and then I had to run away. Had a tour to England. I told him that, listen, Andy, I can't go back.
I'm like in the bush. I don't see anyone. I don't see my family.
Where I grew up, you know, in Chimanimani, they might be, you know, starving to death, like, because you can't get job. If you know you live in Chimanimani, you have to have someone who is working in Harare who can kind of sponsor you with some money, that sort of way. So even in Harare now, there's no jobs. So it's like, I can imagine, you know, some of them are like, it's not, it's very, very bad. I met one of the famous musicians called Andy Brown, and I would say we play all over Zimbabwe, like, but it was not safe for me, because you do like an advert for the government, right? Then the next thing, everybody sees you on television, and you know, I want to get a bus from the town. I'm living to a city center, and when you get on the bus, everyone is like, I know you from the television, and there are some who, you know, like, who doesn't like you because of, you know, working with the, you know, with the government, and some they like you, so it was like a threat. But I've been here for 4.5 years now. I never see any troubles. Like, most of the people I met, they're all friendly. You know, it's different with, you know, England where I was before.
The infamous cranes, symbolic creativity of Belfast. And the waterfront and the Odyssey, and that's just fantastic, you know. You just see the whole Laggenside development now, just decent to see it all planned out and really growing, you know, and the whole city's growing. There's just so many changes, but all really good, you know. And it's been very encouraging for a place that's been kind of, I don't know, stuck in history and stuck in problems that we're now seeing massive changes very quickly, which is now we're struggling to cope with.
I was born and raised in West Belfast. I come from a very large family, all singers and musicians. And we played music from when we were children and got rewards on Friday nights, like sweets, if you could play a note on the harmonica, or sometimes a scrubbing board or spoons, you know. Sometimes we'd stretch elastics across the shoebox. We couldn't afford a guitar at the time. People outside their doors would sit and play guitars and sing. So I was surrounded by that, and initially pretty influenced by it. When I was growing up, meeting people from different parts of Belfast, it was a totally no-no, because there was a wall around Belfast, you know, a cage, and you had to be searched going to the town if you wanted to go to the pictures. You had to go through the cage and get searched. So you were very much aware that when you left your area, that you were going somewhere that wasn't your area, where you were a stranger. And that may have only been a few hundred yards from where you lived.
From raising cars to walking, it's hard to adjust. From catching a bullet to catching a bus, the mind is a prison.
Later, when I would record a song, I would play it back and say, now, why did I actually say that? And it was about people's minds being prisons. And that was about people who withdrew into both their own communities and into their own homes. And for a long time, segregation here was unbelievable.
A lot of our communities are quite enclosed, which is a shame. And I think there is sort of moves to make Catholic and Protestant communities work together, but I think we need to move more towards true multiculturalism.
Take a plane, child, to another country far away.
I think the sad thing in Northern Ireland at the minute is, yes, the troubles have stopped, but it's like we've turned our hatred for, you know, it used to be Catholic, Protestant, now it's, oh, at Polish out or whichever, and I think it's very sad. I hope it just in some small ways spreads out and doesn't just affect people at the gig, but maybe helps their attitude towards people when they next meet a Polish person around the street. They don't necessarily assume anything about them. Because I think it would be a terrible thing for this country if we finished hating one thing and started hating another. I mean, there's nothing like music, you know, music to heal the soul.
Gonna take a walk, child.
I think the audiences at the beginning of an evening are a bit like the bunny in the headlights. What are these people going to do? Because they see instruments, as I did, that I had never seen before. And they see people of different colours, creeds, ethnic backgrounds, and from all over the world starting to plug in their guitars and hook up their drums. And all the musicians really get together and just play for the music. And the first thing you notice is the head starting to go, and then the foot starts to go, and by the end of the day, they're banging the drums and they're loving it.
We're having a massive impact on the community of Northern Ireland, people we come across, plus it's really impacting our own lives, you know, opportunities within our own careers as well. I just feel very fortunate that I'm in this position, you know. I've come across some amazing people, not only skilled musically, but just passionate.
My tunes, or the tunes I play, are based on melody, and the people I listen to, you know, are usually those who are driven by strong melodies, like myself.
Can you start again? Just.
Inspiration is not something you can go and buy a bottle of. It's always a challenge to play with people not from your culture and not from the same background, because they are influenced by different things, and it's beautiful.
Some of the African guys will play a sort of a three-chord pattern and repeat it. And it's one that runs right through Western music as well. But what's interesting is the take on the rhythm. A lot of what we do is based around improvisation, so it's a dialogue, it's a polylogue, if you like, and all sorts of going on, and you have to listen and respond. What the Motion Project is doing is saying, yes, these guys are other. They are different, but that's good. And here's what you can do when you put all different people together, different traditions, different influences. It's like putting different notes together on the guitar.
Because of the nature of the band, the size of it, and the countries involved, it's quite a symbolic thing for the Motion Project. It's our kind of symbolic coming together, you know, and having a good time through our love of music, really, you know. On stage, it's very different. It's always chaos. There's always problems with the sound. There's always, we're doing festivals, so we're like 5 minutes to set up. You've got a range of different instruments, and there's all those technical, logistical nightmares on stage. So we're always up there struggling with that element. But then, at some point, the kind of energy and the kind of the family vibe comes through, and there's a real connection with the audience. That something magical is happening here.
Not about people playing music for you and you sitting watching. It's not about people dancing for you and you watching. We're hoping that everybody will get up, that you'll join in. There'll be an opportunity later on for everybody to play. There'll definitely be an opportunity later on for everybody to dance. So really, just to say, I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful day.
Yes.
Have lots of fun.
My daughter, Liana, my wife, Yana, and my mommy, Marta.
It's kind of like a family party. That's all the people we've been working with throughout the year, all our musician artists. And it's just an event to bring everybody together for food, music, dance. And it's a celebration, really. I mean, there's loads of different cultures within this room.
Project, and I'm having a ball with the musicians. Met just lovely people. Lovely people.
If you move into a new country, what normally happens is people, they want to know who you are, you know, but they will never appreciate you if they don't know what you do.
It's all to do about music, so we all love music. It's good. We're having good time, like, you know, even like I made the drummer from Slovakia, and we've got, you know, the drummer from Zimbabwe. They all play different, but it's the same instruments, it's the drum.
You know, I always try to change the places I work, and as long as I can develop myself, you know, I'll stay here.
These instruments, the boron, the djembes, the conga drums, they would normally see them if they're at a live concert or on TV. For them to actually be able to play them and people like ourselves to show them the techniques, they really, really do enjoy it.
Something magical is happening here that we're projecting out onto the audience. And I see everybody smiling, enjoying themselves and letting themselves go. And I suppose the word is freedom.